This is the tale of an African child, born on a slave ship, crossing the Atlantic from the coast of Guinea in 1729. His dear mother dies in childbirth. Arriving in Colombia with his master, he was soon orphaned, his father reportedly committing suicide to avoid a life of slavery. At 3 years old, the toddler was sent to England to live as a page to three spinsters of Royal Greenwich in the southeast of London. In those days, this would have been a countryside village, genteel and refined. A far cry from the slave and trading port of Spanish America, where he began his life. Baptized Charles Ignatius, after the founder of the Jesuits, he was, like many a young black child in those days, renamed. His new mistresses saw in the plump, affable child the comic page of Miguel Cervantes' Don Quixote. His new name, given by his mistresses, Sancho. And so, Charles Ignatius Sancho takes his place in a land that he does not know and which is largely hostile to those of his color. Unbowed by his obvious challenges, Sancho thrives, nevertheless. His quick wit and winning ways gaining him favor with John, Duke of Montague. Montague takes a shine to the lad and requests the honor of teaching him to read and write, a request vehemently denied by the sisters three. The standard idea at the time being that blacks who are educated in any way will lose their naturally docile natures.
Not so is friendship's gentle sway, mild and serene as the dawning day, mild and serene as the dawning day.
Thwarted by these sisters from learning to read, he sneaks away from them on a regular basis, joining John at Montague House in nearby Blackheath. There he learns all the arts and skills of a high-class valet. Music, French, dance. Later in life, this man, refusing to be pigeonholed by British society, becomes an actor alongside his friend David Garrick. Correspondent with England's first great comic novelist, Lawrence Sterne, and is painted by his adopted country's greatest portraitist, Thomas Gainsborough. With humour and skill, the man born with nothing achieved greatness. composition. French and, of course, hairdressing. At a time when most of his black brothers and sisters were enslaved in the West. Finally, Charles Ignatius Sancho, as a shopkeeper and therefore property owner of Westminster, was able to cast his vote in the parliamentary elections of 1774 and 1780, the year of his death. The first man of African origin to do so. A remarkable survivor. A skilled composer of early solo part songs and dances. A member of the royal household and a prolific letter writer. Sancho is, quite simply, a hero. To rise above the given lot society has handed them. Refusing to be a victim and never giving up. A hero for all newcomers and outsiders, both then and, I believe, forever. It is my very great honor and privilege to present to you the music of Charles Ignatius Sancho.